It is graduation ceremony of Belmont Secretarial College. Mrs. Pierce shook hands enthusiastically with all the students, convinced of their bright future in their career. However, when it comes to Lucy's turn, her face turns sour.
Good luck, my dear. Surely my surprise also thinks that no one will ever hire me as an employee. I'm tired of being poor. If only I can get a job.
Fading off into her own imagination. It was a bright afternoon when Lucy came running into the kitchen.
I've got a job! I've got my first job ever!
Oh! Are you serious, darling?
Yes, Mother! I'll be starting this Monday!
Oh, you never! Fancy that now! Who would have thought it? A new day has come. A new
Lucy is standing outside the Ross and Bannister's firm, waiting for the door to be opened. A while later, an elderly man came hobbling up the stairs, jingling a bunch of keys in his hands.
Ah, punctuality is the courtesy of kings, but a hard necessity for new brooms, eh? You are a new broom, I suppose.
I'm Lucy Beck, the new secretary.
Let's just hope you stay longer than the others one. Come in, Miss Beck. Come into the parlor, said the spider to the fly. I'm Harry Dodd, 30 years with Ross and Bannisters, retired with a silver watch and now come back to haunt the place. Can't keep away, you see. Like someone else I could mention, but won't.
Harry Dark continues to show around the office to Lucy and telling her what she's supposed to do before finally showing her to her desk.
Oh, another thing. As an electric typewriter, a different typewriter. If it goes a little wrong now and again, just ignore it. I also have got you a big bottle of liquid paper, the thing they invent.
I am used to electric typewriters, and I don't make mistakes. I've got a diploma.
Yes, yes, my dear. They all had.
Harry Dark left Lucy alone in the office. Lucy sits at her table, arranging her stuff, making the table more Lucy-like.
I better get on with the work.
Lucy starts typing using the electric typewriter.
Dear sirs, I'm pleased to inform you that
QWERTYUIOP
and Bannisters have introduced a new
QWERTYUIOP
of sunburst cushions in
QWERTYUIOP
orange and
QWERTYUIOP.
What happened? What happened? Such strange mistakes. Thank God there had been no one to notice.
Lucy tried to retype, She focused her mind on what she is typing on. She was sure she had not made any mistake. She was totally bewildered when she saw what was written on the letter that she had just typed.
Dear sirs,
you are sitting in my chair.
To inform you that,
go away.
A new line of,
we do not want you here.
Cushions in yellow,
silly chit,
and pink.
QWL2IOP.
Let's hope you stay longer than the other ones.
Lucy cries. She tore the sheets out of the typewriter and threw them into the waste paper basket. She put a fresh paper in and began again. She fixed her eyes on the keyboard this time to ensure that no mistake would be made. Dear sirs, we are pleased to inform you that Ross and Bannisters have introduced a new line of sunburst cushion. The typewriter took over, each letter moving on its own. Lucy moved her hands and watched what the typewriter had to say.
You can't keep me out that way. You'll never be rid of me. Never. Why don't you go? No one wants you here. No one likes you. Go away before...
Lucy stood up and ran to the door.
Left the same day she came, shot off like a scalded cat.
No! Lucy composed herself and sat back at her chair, starting to type again, trying to reason with the typewriter. Are you from outer space?
Idiot.
Who are you?
Miss Broom.
How do you do? I am Miss Beck.
Go away, Miss Beck.
Why should I?
I am secretary here.
No, you are not. I am.
QWLTYUIOP. QWLTYUIOP.
Lucy was adamant. She was determined to finish up the letter. Whenever the typewriter came out with a mistake, Lucy was ready with her liquid paper.
You are drowning me! Help! Please! I hate you!
Yours faithfully, George Ross. Finally, the letter was successfully finished. Lucy smiled, filled with satisfaction. Lucy was already at her place in the office when Mr. Ross came in.
Any telephone messages?
On your desk, Mr. Ross.
Did you have trouble with the machine, Miss Beck? It's only just come back from being serviced.
I'm sorry, sir. It keeps going wrong.
It's okay. But if it does that again, then we might have to do something about it.
Lucy was scared because she knew Mr. Ross was referring to letting her go, as too many liquid paper means incompetence for a secretary. Around lunch hour, Harry Dahl came into the office. He saw Lucy still being there.
Still here?
Mr. Duck, who is Miss Broom? Tell me about her.
Wrong question, Miss Beck.
Who was Miss Broom?
You're right, little lion. Need to be if you are going to take on Miss Broom. She was old Mr. Bannister's secretary for 43 years. Her stiff old fingers tapping out the letters one by one, with her nose nearly on the keyboard, so short-sighted she became by then. None of you are touch typing for her. You can't wonder she hates you, young girls. with your fingers flying over the keys like white butterflies and your eyes gazing out into the sunshine. They gave her the push, you know.
After 43 years?
Well, she was past it, wasn't she? Of course they wrapped it up in tissue paper, gave her a brass clock and shook her hand and waved her goodbye. She didn't want to go, didn't have anywhere worth going to, a back seat, a grass ring, the old bag didn't have any family who owned her. This place was her home. This job was all she lived for.
Though I feel quite sorry for her, but it's my job now. I need it. She can't have it forever. It's not fair. It's not fair. It's my turn now.
Back at Lucy's house, Uncle Bert was waiting for her. He gestured for Lucy to sit next to him.
Thanks. I don't get paid till Friday, you know? No good trying to touch me for a fiver.
You don't think much of me, do you? Who are you to set up yourself as a judge and jury? You don't know what it's like, not being wanted. A little kindness would help.
Uncle Bert, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Uncle Bert, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too, Lucy. I know it's a nuisance having me here.
No, no, it isn't. We want you.
Both of them then sat together, catching up. It is Wednesday. Lucy puts a sheet of paper in the typewriter.
Q-W-E-R-T-Y-U-I-O-P, Q-W-E-R-T-Y-U-I-O-P, Q-W-E-R-T-Y-U-I-O-P.
Dear Miss Broom, Mr. Dark told me you used to be a secretary to Mr. Bannister.
I am.
I am sorry to have to tell you that Mr. Bannister passed on 3 years ago at the age of 86.
Liar! I don't believe you.
It is true, Miss Broom. I've seen his grave in the cemetery. It is not far from yours. I went along last night and left you flowers. I did. Mr. Dark is worried about Mr. Bannister. He does not know how he will manage without you.
He can manage without me, alright. He told me to go. Brass clock. What did I want with brass clock? I wanted my job.
They only asked you to go because they were worried about your health. Mr. Dark told Mr. Bannister was always saying how much he missed you. Truly. He said Mr. Bannister complained none of the new girls were any good. There was no one like you, he said. He must miss you. He's probably in an awful muddle up there, mislaying his wings, losing his harp. He needs someone to look after him. Goodbye, Miss Broom. Best of luck in your new job. Yours sincerely, Lucy Beck, Secretary. Lucy folded the letter into a paper dart and sent it sailing out of the window. Lucy continued working. She had no problem with the typewriter since then. Mr. Ross is happy with Lucy as his new secretary.
You are the champion. However did you do it?